You know, Apple can be one of the most predictable companies in the world, and when you least expect it, they come out with something that nobody was waiting for. So, I'm Jaime Rivera, this is Pocket Now, and these are our top 5 predictions for WWDC 2013 that's happening on June 10th. Number 5 is iRadio, or whatever this music subscription service that's been rumored for the longest time is going to be called. And the reason why I'm leaving it last is because, well, first of all, Steve Jobs never believed in music subscription services, and I don't see the company changing that anytime soon. Second of all, because we've heard that Apple struggled to be able to land these deals with record companies. And third, because Apple has their own music event happening in the fall. It's actually called the Music Event, so it doesn't make any sense for them to launch anything right now at WWDC, even if it could probably happen by the fall. Number 4 is App Store related enhancements that are mostly focused on you being able to try applications before you buy. This has been a small rumor out there that Apple is working on bringing this service into applications because a lot of us are annoyed at the fact that we can't test something before we buy. And for those of you that read the terms of service, anybody? Well, sadly, every purchase that you make is final by the time you buy it. You can't really just give it back, even though Apple sometimes helps you and gives you back your money. Apparently, we will be able to test applications, and hopefully there will be some sort of trial periods for music, hopefully, or whatever other services we might get. But stay tuned. We do see some enhancements on the App Store coming as our fourth prediction. Number 3 is hardware, and this is going to be kind of difficult. Usually either Apple is blocking their leak radar recently, or we haven't received many leaks of products that could probably be launched at this event. By the time the iPhone 5 was announced, we had already seen the phone. Pretty much everything was already leaked, and most probably we will not be getting an iPhone, but we have received a ton of leaks of the iPad 5 that is. So we either get a rehash of the iPad mini with a Retina display, or we will be getting the iPad 5, hopefully, as we have been seeing final photos of what the hardware would look like. So stay tuned, we probably will be getting hardware, probably just a rehash of current products, or we could probably be getting the iPad 5 at least. Number 2 is iOS 7. There is no holding this one back. Tim Cook already mentioned it at D11, and it's gonna happen. We are gonna be getting a new version of iOS. And considering the fact that iOS 6 was a complete disaster, this is most likely gonna be a big revamp. And why? Because Scott Forstall is no longer there. So the person that came up with the whole concept of iOS is no longer there. And we will probably be getting new enhancements and new design coming from Johnny Ive and Craig Federighi. Sadly, rumors out there say that all we're getting is actually a flatter version of iOS, and I would just hold on for the event because we'll most probably be either surprised or, I don't know, dismayed. We'll keep you posted on this one, but yes, iOS 7 is happening. Hopefully not only iOS 7 is getting improved, hopefully Siri as well, but again, rumors are rumors and Siri is another one out there. And the top number 1 prediction that we have for WWDC 2013 is pretty much the same one we have for every Apple event. One more thing. The reason why we have one more thing again here is because Apple's been extremely secretive lately. We've been hearing about an iWatch every now and then, and probably we will be getting hardware, but we don't know exactly which hardware aside from an iPad or a rehash of a current product. So the question is if Apple is willing to defy whatever other companies are doing now with Google Glass and with watches out there, or if Apple's gonna sit in their laurels for another year. Judging from what we saw at D11, I don't see Tim Cook doing that this year, but again, it's been half the year already and we haven't seen anything, so it's about time for you to act, Apple. So that leads me to the question of this top 5. What do you predict for WWDC 2013? Do you predict that we will be getting an iWatch? Do you predict that we will be getting new hardware, iOS 7? What are your predictions? Leave us a comment down below and tell us what you expect to happen at this event on June 10th. That's it for today's top 5. Thank you very much for watching. WWDC happens on June 10th and we'll be covering everything live as it happens. So be sure to follow us on social media. Also give this video a thumbs up if you like what you saw. I am Jaime Rivera. Thank you very much for watching. See you then.